So today I'm going to talk a little bit about, I don't know, going back to the past of your childhood sometime, your growing up, your teenage years, and some kind of, I don't know, there's an availability moment with innocence, and innocence of acceptance, innocence of a new understanding. And in this ridiculous, I don't know, I don't have time right now to take a picture of the photo to put it onto the internet, so I'll just try to flash it. But here's an old picture of me, and I'm young, I'm very young, and I'm here at a lake, and I don't know what I was doing. You know, I wasn't trying to be anything yogi, I wasn't trying to be anything like this. So I'm like, well, what is the deal? Because so here's the little ducks. And they're all having their moment also. Some are more timid and some aren't, you know. And just like humans. You know, we all have our episodes. And I even have this one over here, a little reticent one. So all of this is going on. And I'm wondering, what did I do that for? You know, looking stupid, looking foolish, putting myself out there in the actual public eye, in a public place, in a park, looking like a nimna. You know, what about what other people think, what about all of that, you know, what about that self, aren't you embarrassed, aren't you shy, type of thing. Okay, well, oddly I am extra because I'm not wearing the garb, so yeah. So when I go back to finding these moments into, like, you know, you're the direction of philosophy, the direction of a new understanding of yourself and other people. Go back to when you were really young and you were aware of that innocence being available, that you could just commune there with ducks. I mean, here I am communing with ducks. So why was that necessary? It's not even important. The fact is, do I need this now as proof? You know, do I need this as proof? Because this is such a proof-ridden world, isn't it? It's a proof-ridden world. Do I need this as proof that I'm a yogi? Because there are so many naysayers. And I don't want to live my life in the proof epic, tantrum. Of there are necessities and I'm not wearing the garb, so now I have the photo, you know what I mean? And so it just keeps surmounting for them. Seems like when we get into the balance and the upset for them, it's just increases, and they need this and they need that, and it's just like when we get into if we look at the ducks here, we have some that are just so happy to be near me immediately, and they're just like accepting, they're wide-eyed and bushy-tailed, and there's not a problem, okay, not a problem at all, you know. But Mr. Reticence, you know, when you have reticence there, we're like, okay, so what is the deal, you know? He needs proof. This little guy needs proof. He needs proof in the pudding. He needs that. You know, so we're living in a world with a lot of people who need more and more proof. It's not a blood test. You don't take a blood test. There isn't anything like that. You know? So it's just interesting. I believe my mother took this shot. It could have been a friend, a girlfriend. I don't know. But it's very, very cute. A cute moment early on in my life. And not everybody has this. Not everybody's going to have a photo as genuine and ridiculous, you know, their Shiva self. They're just not. And I'm lucky I do have it. And I'm not out here trying to go look and see what I have, and I have the proof. This is exactly what we're trying to avoid. I don't want people to have to walk through hoops, that they have to wear sheets, that they have to have photos of Shiva moments with ducks. I don't want this to go on. I want us to have and genuine, non-proven, non-pressure life. And when we have religion all around, you know, religion, this religion and that religion, still on the pressure mode, still on the pressure, they're there saying, hey, there needs to be more proof, there needs to be more proof, you know. Just as, I hate to use the Catholic religion, but they're the ones with the blood on the hand of Jesus and all of that. I can't remember the name of it, but that type of thing. They're proof-driven human beings. Okay? They've been taught to be proof-driven. So that's a perfect example. Well, anyway, this is my blood on the hand. And if that's enough for them, I don't know. It seems like they will want more. You know? So yeah, we end up with that fight. We shouldn't have to.